You might have heard about the P-shot and its use in erectile dysfunction. Surely, most of you have the imagination to figure out what P that is that's being shot at. But what are we shooting with? What is platelet-rich plasma, also known as PRP, and what is the rationale to use it? My name is Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. PRP has been around since the 1970s and was initially used in the field of hematology. When you draw a blood sample from your arm and put it into a centrifuge and you spin it around with a certain speed and for a sufficient amount of time, the centrifugal force will divide the blood into different layers. On top, you will have the plasma containing very few cells, and the red stuff at the bottom are erythrocytes, the red blood cells. Then there is a small layer in the middle, which is called the buffy coat, consisting of white blood cells and platelets. If you now remove the red blood cells and you submit the rest to a different spinning program, you will get PRP, platelet-rich plasma. And depending on how you spin it, you will have a choice between a product that only contains platelets or a product that's rich on white blood cells. I'll come back to that point a little later, but first, what do you need platelets for? Some of you may know that they are essential for blood clotting. If you have a wound, platelets will play a central role in stopping the bleeding. But platelets are much more than that. Let's say you have a wound and it's not clean, but there are bacteria in it as well. Platelets will help with the immune response of the body to attack the intruders. They are packed with small bombs, we call them granules, which they throw at them. In addition to that, platelets contain a lot of biochemistry in these granules, which could be summarized as growth factors. Generally, growth factors are a good thing, right? Because we are talking tissue healing and regeneration. This is what we want when treating certain conditions with PRP, like an Achilles tendonitis or if we want to reinforce hair growth. We want healing, regeneration, and rejuvenation. You see, the applications of PRP are numerous. Besides in musculoskeletal disorders, PRP is used in the fields of cardiac surgery, pediatric surgery, gynecology, plastic surgery, ophthalmology, and, of course, urology. Mostly, we are talking erectile dysfunction. What will happen after the injection is tissue regeneration. I will cover this part in a separate video. Lately, Peyronie's disease has also been tried with some promising results. So, how do we make the platelets release the good stuff? We activate them by adding calcium chloride and or thrombin. Calcium chloride will make them empty their granules into the plasma. Thrombin will convert fibrinogen into fibrin. Fibrin, that's the glue in blood clotting, you know, that yellow brownish stuff you can see at a healing wound. 3/4 of the fibrinogen are found in the plasma, but also platelets contain some fibrinogen. Fibrinogen cleavage will form a platelet gel that confines the growth factors to the chosen site. But you don't always want that. It depends on the site and what PRP is used for. Some physicians don't activate the PRP and rely on the spontaneous activation at the injection site. So basically, we have several options for the final PRP product. Activated versus non-activated, pure, containing just platelets, or leukocyte-rich and high or low density fibrin network after activation, depending on whether we want it to be more gel-like. What about white blood cells? Do we need them? This is still a matter of debate. Roughly speaking, leukocytes will likely add to the effect of the platelets, but leukocytes promote an inflammatory response as well. Inflammation is a normal thing in wound healing and is always observable. As I understand the scientific results published so far, it could be beneficial to have that response in acute injuries, whereas a pure PRP may be the better choice for chronic conditions. But this is just my interpretation. Another very important point is the inconsistent quality of PRP. Because every person is different. Since PRP is made from one's own blood, there may be substantial changes between persons regarding platelet concentrations. And even within the same individual, PRP from two different days may not be equal. This is a problem because if we do science with it, we have to keep in mind that there is not one PRP, but that there are several options. One may be superior over the other in terms of efficacy in a given condition. So in erectile dysfunction, there could be a certain type that's more effective than the other. And in addition to that, there are differences in PRP between people. This is probably one of the reasons why results differ in the studies performed. Treatment with PRP has a number of advantages as the risk for side effects and complications is minimal because it is your own cellular material that is given back to you in a concentrated and purified form. So when injecting PRP into the penis, it's basically infection, bleeding, and pain that can happen, but the risk is minimal. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.